Hi everyone, I'm Phil Nash from DataStacks, and this is how to use Readability.js with LangChain.js and Astra DB. Now in a previous video, I talked about how Readability.js was a library and part of Firefox that strips away everything from a web page aside from the important content. That's useful because when you're ingesting data from the web to use in a RAG application, you don't want to include headers, footers, sidebars, and all the extra parts of a web page that aren't the main content. You don't want to have to inspect each and every page you want to ingest to pick out the content as well. Readability.js is good at doing that for you automatically. So in this video, I'm just going to show you how that all fits together in an ingestion pipeline using LangChain.js. We're going to take a URL, fetch the HTML, use Readability.js to get the text content, split it into chunks, turn those chunks into vector embeddings, and store them all in Astra DB. Okay? So let's take a look at the code. I have already kicked off by importing all my dependencies. So we have the HTML web-based loader, that's gonna load a URL. We have the Mozilla readability transformer, that's the readability.js part. Got a recursive character text splitter, OpenAI embeddings, and Astra DB vector store. I also got the URL we're gonna use, that's a blog post that I wrote on creating vector embeddings in Node.js. And so let's get started. We're gonna start with we're going to start with our loader, which is going to use that HTML web-based loader. And to that, we just pass the URL. From there, we're going to create ourselves a splitter using the recursive character text splitter. Okay, we've got a couple of options. Our max character count of 1,000 and a chunk overlap of 200. Those are pretty good kind of average settings, I think, for the recursive character text splitter. We need a transformer, and that is our Mozilla readability transformer. We need some embeddings, const embeddings, the OpenAI embeddings. What we'll use for that is just the, we'll just add the model text embedding three small. And then we'll set up our vector store. That's using our Astra DB vector store. And for that, we're going to pass in the embeddings. Once we've done that, we need to set up a bunch of the credentials. Now I have these credentials already set in my environment. This is the Astra DB application token. We have an endpoint set up. So that's process DB API endpoint. And we have the collection we're going to use, which I'm just going to call vector store. And then we need to add the collection options as well. This is going to be the options for the vector index on the store. So text embedding three small has 1536 dimensions, and we'll use a cosine metric for similarity. Great. And what we need to do for that is just await for the vector store to initialize. Cool, so that's kind of all our setup. The rest we have to do is just set up our pipeline. So we're gonna get some documents by using the loader to load the web page. We're going to then create a sequence of events. It's not a very long sequence, this one, but I like the sort of pipeline of events that LangChain.js gives you. So we're gonna take our transformer, and then we're going to pipe the results of the transformer through the text splitter. And that will give us some documents at the end of it. So const the actual documents that we're going to store, document is the sequence dot, not transform, but invoke the sequence. So we'll take the documents, or the single document, it turns out, the web loader, the HTML web loader returns. We're going to invoke the sequence with that. That's going to transform the document. So that's putting it through Readability.js to extract just the text content. We're going to pipe that through the splitter. And then once we've done that, we'll just await vector store, add documents with those documents that were created. And so that's all the code we need. Like, it's 35 lines according to this, but most of that is just set up, importing and setting things up. This is really the meat of the whole issue. We load some documents. We turn them into a sequence using the transformer and a splitter. We wait for that to work using the document returned by the loader. and then we add those to the vector store. And just to see, this is my collection, or this is my database in Astra DB. Currently doesn't have a collection, so the LangChain code is going to set for me as well. So let's run this. I'm using an env file and Node.js to load that. So if we run that right now, what it's going off and doing is setting everything up, setting up our Astra DB vector store. It's creating a collection for us called vector store using those vector settings that we set up. And then is going to load that web page and is going to pass it through that ingestion pipeline. So again, it's going to run it through the Mozilla transformer. It's going to split the documents up. It's going to send them off to the database using the OpenAI embeddings to chunk them up, to turn them into vector embeddings. And it's done. So if we refresh our data collection now, we'll find we have a vector store. And in that vector store, we have 11 records of a bunch of documents. And what you can see from these documents is that there's no HTML knocking around. There's nothing there at all. All we gave it was a URL and that transformer, and we got just plain text out the other side, chunked into different chunks. We can see that better in our JSON view here, showing that, yeah, this text is just text. We lost all the HTML, but we didn't lose, and we got all of the relevant stuff. Great. So that is how to quickly set up an ingestion pipeline for web pages using Readability.js, LangChain.js, and Astra DB.